Today, we're talking about woolly mammoths and why they die. Now, the world has changed a lot over its long, long, long life and has seen countless animal species come and go. Perhaps the most famous animal species being the dinosaurs, which lived on Earth for a whopping 180 million years, which is still actually only a small percentage of Earth's 4.5 billion year lifespan. Another one of these famous animals is the great woolly mammoth. Now, woolly mammoths as we know them first arrived around 400,000 years ago and only disappeared from the Arctic Circle as recently as 4,000 years ago. Woolly mammoths weren't quite as enormous as you might think, measuring about the same as a modern African elephant, around 13 to 15 feet tall, which is still not exactly titchy. Like elephants, they were armed with two enormous tusks and powerful trunks, as well as a thick covering of fur, which helped them to survive colder climates. So, why did these woolly giants die out? Well, scientists actually have yet to fully agree on the main reason, but there are a number of factors to keep in mind. Firstly, at the time most mammoths seem to have begun to die out, around 40,000 years ago, the Earth was going through a major climate change. This may have caused a shrinkage in the natural habitat of the woolly mammoths. Our distant ancestors had also started to make more frequent use of weapons in their hunting expeditions, suggesting that we became more efficient killers and were able to hunt the giants more successfully. It's worth bearing in mind that larger animal species tend to be more susceptible to these type of events, as they tend to have smaller populations and lower reproduction rates. As the population decreased even further, genetic defects became more common. Now, these defects could cause things such as a weaker sense of smell, disruption to their mating patterns, and less efficient processing of proteins, making it harder for the animals to feed and eat sufficiently. It's likely that these factors coinciding is what made the mammoths die out. These days, aside from biological remains and fossil records, the only other record of mammoths is their presence on cave paintings all over the world. These paintings help to give us an idea of the native wildlife that was around at the time of the paintings. The recent discovery of genetic material from relatively fresh and well-preserved remains has raised the idea that mammoths might be cloned and reintroduced into the animal kingdom. Though, as you may remember from our previous video about cloning extinct species, this might be possible one day, but certainly not anytime soon, sadly. So there you have it. That's our explanation of why woolly mammoths died out.
Our planet is home to a vast multitude of species that have been thriving in its flora and fauna since time immemorial. As humans, we may think we're in charge, but in fact, mankind is strangely insignificant in the grand scheme of the Earth. Indeed, the world's 7.6 billion people represent just 0.01% of all living things. Yet, since the dawn of civilization, humanity has caused the loss of a staggering 83% of all wild mammals and 50% of all plant life. Although extinctions are nothing new and have been happening since life began on Earth, our presence on this planet has certainly helped speed up the process. Be it climate change, destruction of natural habitats, interbreeding of animals, or simply hunting for food, humans have been responsible for the extinction of much of this planet's fauna, with more in danger of extinction. So, which are some of these creatures? And how close are they to being completely wiped out forever from the face of this planet? You curious? Discover more. Know more. Southern rockhopper penguin. Distinguished by spiky yellow and black feathers on their heads, blood-red eyes, a red-orange beak, and pink webbed feet, rockhoppers are among the world's smallest penguins, standing at just 20 inches tall. Although they look adorable, the population of these penguins has declined by more than 30% over the last 30 years. Rockhopper colonies on the Falkland Islands, UK, were once the largest, but commercial overfishing, pollution and oil spills have cut the penguins' numbers dramatically. These activities have not only warmed the ocean around their habitats, but have also drastically reduced their food source. Currently, rockhoppers are classified as vulnerable by the International Union for Conservation of Nature, the IUCN. Hawksbill turtle. Sporting unique beak-like mouths, beautiful amber-coloured patterned shells, and a unique V-shaped lower jaw that gives it a hawk-like appearance, hawksbill turtles roam throughout the tropical waters of the Atlantic, Pacific, and Indian Oceans. With a diet comprising mainly of coral reef sponges, the loss of coral reef habitat around the world due to warming up of the oceans is a primary threat to hawksbill turtles. Another threat to the hawksbill's life is their beautiful shell. They were hunted for hundreds of years in huge numbers for the tortoise shell that was used in many types of jewelry and trinkets. Harvesting hawksbill turtles for their shell nearly drove the population to extinction. Today, IUCN classifies the hawksbill as endangered, polar bear. These snowy white furballs may look cuddly, but in fact are twice the size of a tiger, guzzle through 12,325 calories a day, for which they rely almost exclusively on a diet of seals. But thanks to climate change, the Arctic is heating up faster than anywhere else, and sea ice is shrinking at 14% per decade. Even today, in the middle of the bitter cold Arctic winter, there is about 770,000 square miles less sea ice as compared to 2010. Because of this, the polar bear's only food source, seals, has also reduced drastically, leading to a starving population of bears, which are fast dying out. Indeed, polar bears are considered endangered in the US and are listed as vulnerable by the IUCN because their sea ice habitat is under threat from climate change. In fact, the World Wildlife Fund, WWF, is conducting research to identify and conserve areas in which these bears feed, den, and give birth, in an effort to conserve their population. Dugong. This one sounds like a Pokemon, doesn't it? Well, it's real, and it's in danger. Historically, dugongs, one of the four species of sea cows, have lived along almost all the coasts of the Indo-Pacific Ocean around India, East Africa, Malaysia, and Western Australia. Dugongs are important for maintaining healthy sea meadows, which are an important source of food to them and innumerable species of fish. But they're suffering pressures on their coastal habitat, and in many places their numbers are plummeting. Why, you ask? Well, coastal development, industrial activities, and water pollution are eating away at the very seagrass on which these flippers depend for their food. To make it worse, if dugongs do not eat their fill of seagrass, they don't mate, and baby dugongs are not born. Moreover, to add to the problem, dugongs often get accidentally entangled in fishing nets laid out for other fish and become innocent victims. The sharp fall in the dugong's population has led the IUCN to classify it as vulnerable on the red list of threatened species, vaquita porpoise. Discovered in 1958, the vaquita is already on the brink of extinction. This elusive porpoise roams the waters of Mexico's Gulf of California, and its population has dropped by an alarming 97% in recent years. So, what's causing the vaquita to be wiped out? The answer's pretty common: illegal fishing practices. Vaquitas share waters with the totoba fish, which are sought after for their swim bladders, believed to cure a variety of illness and diseases in Chinese medicine, and can sell for up to $8,500 per kilogram in the black market. Much like the dugong, the innocent vaquita gets entangled in the fishing nets set out for the totoba fish and drowns. Indeed, the vaquita's population, as per the International Committee for the Recovery of the Vaquita, as of 2019, is only 10 in the whole world. This has led to the IUCN classifying this porpoise as critically endangered. Mexican grey wolf. Once wandering through Arizona, New Mexico, Texas, and northern Mexico, the Mexican grey wolf became the most endangered species of wolf in the world when settlers moved to the southwest, bringing the livestock industry with them. Mexican grey wolves began to lose the habitat vital to their survival. In addition, hunters killed off deer, elk, and many other animals that are natural prey for wolves, cutting off their sources of food. And so, with diminishing habitats and few animals to hunt, wolves began preying on livestock. This led to the US Biological Survey killing as many as 900 wolves with rifles, poison, and traps between 1915 and 1925 alone, and driving them to the brink of extinction. As of 2020, only 163 Mexican grey wolves remain, leading the IUCN to classify them as endangered on the Red List of Threatened Species, and also leading to formation of the Mexican Wolf Species Survival Plan, the MWSSP, ceola. With its unusually long horns and white markings on the face, the ceola is a strong symbol for biodiversity in Laos and Vietnam. But unfortunately, it was discovered in 1992, at a time when its population was already extremely threatened. Since not even a single ceola, or Asian unicorns as they're called, exist in captivity to this day, this animal remains a bit of an enigma to us, and we can only venture a guess as to how many remain. But one thing we do know for sure is only 11 ceolas have ever been captured alive on camera. Funnily enough, the ceola is one of the few animals without a price on its head, since it is neither valued as a hunting prize nor in any animal black market. So, what's making it disappear? Well, besides the usual destruction of habitat for agriculture, plantations, and infrastructure, the ceola is also an innocent casualty of snares that are set by villagers for other wild animals. With the very real possibility of only a few hundred of these animals existing today, the IUCN has listed the ceola as critically endangered on the Red List. Further, the WWF has been involved with the protection of the ceola ever since its discovery, improving protection measures at the Vu Cang Nature Reserve in Vietnam, where the ceola was first discovered, and have established two new adjacent ceola reserves in the Tua Tien Hieu and Cang Nam provinces. Amer leopard. Few animals can survive the harsh winters of Russia as well as the Amur leopard. Thanks to its thick fur, large paws and long legs, it can carve out a home even in the thickest of snowfalls. Being at the top of the food chain, the Amur leopard might lack natural predators, but humans, the ultimate predators on Earth, still threaten the cat's existence, and have been actively poaching or illegally hunting it for the past 60 to 70 years. The Amur leopard is poached largely for its beautiful spotted fur. As of today, the Amur leopard stands classified as critically endangered by the IUCN, with about 100 leopards roaming about in the wild and about 180 in protective captivity. Further, anti-poaching brigades are deployed in all areas in which the Amur leopard prowls. To raise awareness, the Russian president, Vladimir Putin, even chose the Amur leopard as one of the mascots for the 2014 Sochi Olympics. Malayan tiger. Thousands of tigers once roamed throughout the dense, forested interior of the Malaysian peninsula, but they are now mainly confined to three protected areas: Belum Temenggor in the north, Taman Negara in the centre, and Endau Rompin to the south. Half of the Malayan tigers which roamed the forests of the Malaysian Peninsula in 2015 were wiped out by 2018. The poachers are mostly from Thailand, Vietnam, and Cambodia, who feed into an illegal trade where it is believed that consuming parts of endangered animals will cure myriad diseases or improve their strength and virility. Furthermore, all of the tigers which live in protected areas descend from just 11 tigers, making them too closely related to sustain a wild population. Needless to say, this makes conservation efforts that much harder, because of which the IUCN has listed these tigers as critically endangered, and has led the Wildlife Conservation Society, the WCS, to work with governments and establish dozens of protected areas across Asia, and collaborate with scientists to breed and bolster the tiger population. Blue whale. Whales have been hunted by mankind since the medieval era, when whale fat, called blubber, was discovered to have innumerable uses, including oil, soaps, perfumes, candles, and cosmetics, among others, making it increasingly valuable in the times gone by. Unfortunately, as technology, boats, and hunting equipment evolved, the rate at which whales were being killed greatly increased and continued to shrink the existing whale populations, especially those of blue whales, as they were coveted by whalers for their large size and were continually hunted until near extinction. The alarming decrease of the whale population on Earth has led the IUCN to classify them as endangered on the Red List of Threatened Species. Furthermore, blue whales are protected under both the Endangered Species Act and the Marine Mammal Protection Act, which has led organizations and companies alike to monitor whale population trends, predict whale routes, and reroute ships and vessels so that they don't collide with whales, maximise efforts to acquire scientific data from dead, stranded and entangled blue whales, and coordinate state, federal and international efforts to implement recovery actions. Thank you.